Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Bipolar Coffee with Daniel. And I just wanted to give you a quick word for today that I came across as I was doing a morning reading. And I'm here at work, and I just, you know, wanted to take a moment to read. And then as I was reading from John chapter 6, came across this scripture, and it really touched me in my heart. And I just wanted to share it with everybody. What it is. So it's John chapter 6 verses 5 through 7. Okay. Actually, maybe even all the way up to 9. But basically, it's where, you know, Jesus got to the side of the Sea of Galilee, and this is where one of the crowds, there he had a large crowd that was following him and everything, because they had seen miraculous healings that he was doing. So, you know, he healed the sick and everything, and you know, these people, they wanted to follow him and see what else they can find out and see, you know. And then it says here that then Jesus went part way up the mountainside, found a level place, and sat down with his disciples. And it was almost time for the Jewish Passover feast, so they were getting ready to celebrate the Jewish Passover feast. But come to verse 5, I just wanted to kind of set the tone of what, you know, where they were at. When it comes to verse 5, it says, when Jesus looked up, and I'm reading out of the Remedy Bible, okay? So when Jesus looked up and saw the great crowd of people coming toward him, he said to Philip, where can we buy food for all these people? Verse 6, Jesus asked him only to provide Philip an opportunity to expand his thinking and strengthen his confidence in him, as Jesus had already decided how he was going to feed them. See, a lot of times, you know, Jesus will, you know, end up putting us in a situation, or not putting us, but allowing us to get into a situation, and wanting us to figure it out, you know, to have faith in him and everything. God already knows how he's going to do it, you know, how he's going to help you out of it, how he's going to guide you. But the thing is that we need to step forth and, you know, do some legwork and do, you know, believe and have faith in him that is going to be taken care of. But we got to do the legwork, okay? We can't just decide to, you know, try to, let God do everything, okay? So Philip was still struggling, in verse 7. Philip was still struggling to see beyond the immediate earthly perspective, okay? A lot of times, we as humans are stuck in the earthly realm. We're like, you know, we look at how are we gonna do it in the earthly realm? How am I gonna do this? How am I gonna, you know, pay the rent? How am I gonna do this? You know, if you're not working, you know, you're thinking, well, how, you know, especially with this gas, the gas prices that are so high right now, well, how am I gonna afford all this gas? You know, well, we are stuck in the earthly realm and trying to think of earthly things on how we're gonna do this, okay? So he answered, even if we had 8 months' wages, it would not be enough food to buy food to feed everyone. And then another one of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, spoke up. We found a young boy with 5 small barley loaves and 2 small fish, but how far will they go among so many? Okay, and I'm just going to go ahead and stop there, because you already know, if you read the Bible, you already know, you know, that Jesus had the people sit down and he did the miracle, you know, and everything, you know, the loaves multiplied and everything, the fish multiplied, and he was able to feed everybody. All right, but the thing that I'm trying to say is we can't just be stuck so much in the world, okay? Yes, we need to do our legwork. If we're needing financial, you know, for, you know, food, gas, rent, or whatever, well, you know, if you're not working, well, have you gone out looking for work? Have you asked God, okay, God, you know, help me get the job that I need, to provide or help me get a job. Not just, you know, give me the perfect job, but, you know, get me a, you know, help me get a job so that way I can, that way I can provide for my family. You know, we can't be so picky. If you're needing something right now, you need something right now. There's so many jobs out there hiring, you know, that it's impossible not to get a job. Okay, there are many, many jobs out there hiring, but so many people are not wanting to work. I don't know why. I don't know. You know, maybe they got their own business going on. You know, the COVID thing, and you know, the losing their jobs made them push themselves to be able to get them, you know, to start their own business, doing whatever. I really don't know. But there are so many jobs out there, you know. So just don't get stuck in the physical and the earthly thoughts of, okay, how am I going to do this? But believe that God is going to help you and he's going to provide for you. You know, believe that he's going to help you get a job. It may not be the perfect job, but that job will help you to get started and to move up and up and up the ladder to be able to get to where you want. But if you're needing something now, then you need to get off your butt and do what you need to do in order to provide. Okay? That's just point blank. That's point blank. Or whatever the situation is. Okay? Whatever the situation is. Just don't look at how I'm going to do it in the physical. Believe that God's going to help you through it. Pray about it. Ask him. And he's going to help you to move forward. Okay? We can't just be stuck in our mind in this physical. We got to be in this physical and in the spiritual realm at all times. All right? Not more in one all the time and less in the other, but we need to have that balance. All right? So just don't be stuck in the earthly. Be in the spiritual and the earthly with the good balance. All right? Well, that's all I wanted to say. That's my message for today, and I hope you guys enjoy. All right? Peace out. God bless.